This is a special theory of relativity. Then the topic is Galilean transformation. What is basically meaning and what kind of transformation is this and what information we will get from the Galilean transformation? So before we proceed into the special theory of relativity, there are some basic fundamentals, some scientific words related to the special theory of relativity, and their information is must. So first of all, frame of reference. Frame of reference is what? Number two, observer. And number third is event. These three words are important to understand the basic idea of special theory of relativity. So the first point is frame of reference. What is frame of reference? What basically information they have? Frame of reference basically are of two type. Number one is known as inertial frame of reference, and number two, they are non-inertial frame of reference. Inertial and non-inertial. If frame is called inertial frame, if that satisfies the Newton's first law of inertia, so there is no acceleration. But in second case, where I have mentioned that this frame is non-inertial, it means there will be acceleration. Sometimes it basically velocity increase, sometimes the velocity of that frame will decrease. So there is acceleration, but in case of one, there is no acceleration and that satisfies the law of inertia. It will remain as it position till that we don't apply the external force. So frame of reference are of two type. Number one is inertial frame and number two is the non-inertial frame, which we classified on the basis of law of inertia. And the second point is related to the observer. Who is observer? Who is an observer? Observer is basically that person who observe the phenomena, who observe the event which occur at any place. So that person is known as an observer. Event is basically any kind of happening which happens into the free space that define in terms of the spatial coordinate and time coordinate. Spatial coordinate means the x, y and z coordinates, and time coordinate is t. So we define or we symbolize this observer by the letter O, and event can be defined in terms of the spatial coordinate, which are x, y and z, and the time coordinate. So any event which happens in our life, we define that with the help of spatial coordinates, and those are x, y, z, where it happens. And the second one is related to the time, at when and where. We generally ask that where it happens, when it happens. So x, y, z is related to the spatial coordinate where and t, when. So x, y, z, t, with the help of these four, coordinates, one can define the event. So these are basic three steps in a special theory of relativity, and these are number one, frame of reference, number two, observer, and number three is event. So after this, we will enter into the Galilean transformation. As I have discussed earlier in introduction, that we observe relative effect in our daily life when one travel through the bus, train or any other mode. So we observe many kind of situations, different situations basically. So Galilean transformation is basically a relationship between the two observations, between the two observers, observations. Like I was traveling through the train, I saw that tree and other plants are moving in opposite direction, but a second person who was working there, who was standing there with respect to me, he observed that no tree, no plant is moving, but only the train is moving. So if we see this statement microscopically or with depth, we see that there are two observations. One observation is of the passenger who is traveling through the train and observe that plant are moving in opposite direction, and second person is there who is standing in the field and see that train is moving. So we have to find out the relationship between these two observations of the two observer. And the first derivation and the first concept basically in this reference comes through from the Galilean transformation. Galilean transformation provides a relationship between the two observations of two different observers. So for this, I have to make a frame of reference. This one is S. This indicates to the X, Y and Z axis. At the center we assume that here the is our observer. So this man is an observer into the S frame, and S frame is a stationary frame, right? And the second frame is S prime frame. This is S prime frame. These are Z prime axis, Y prime axis and X prime axis. And this S prime plane is moving relative to the S plane with the speed V. So V is the relative speed of the S prime plane with respect to the S, and here S plane is a stationary plane. And the observer is O prime. This is O prime observer. So here I have mentioned only two things, that frame of reference S prime. This S prime plane is moving along the positive X direction with the relative speed V. This relative speed V is with respect to the stationary plane, and that plane is S. O and O prime are observers in S prime and S prime, right? So this is the situation. But here, before I go into the detail of frame of references and other concepts, I want to make clear the concept of the frame of reference. Frame of reference is what? This is basically here in the physics. We have converted all the observation terms of the mathematics, in terms of these coordinates. So if you don't know that you see only these coordinate axes, or you know about the real facts, so from where we basically are trying to connect all these things. So for that I have to make a small picture to make it more clear. Suppose a biker, there is a person who is basically traveling through the bike is sitting on the bike, right? So this person sitting here on the bike, and now bike is moving with the speed of, you can say, 50 km per hour, and here across the road there is a person who is just standing in a stationary pole. So, or you can say that this man is sitting somewhere, or you can say that this man is hanging on the tree. So it is in your this situation. But the point is clear that this second man is in stationary form, is in rest position. So this man is just hanging on the branch of a tree, and this second person is moving on the bike, and the speed of the bike is around 50 km per hour. So this is the real situation or real observation of a person. This man see that a person who is sitting on this bike is going at this speed of 50 km per hour. This man may also know. So, and this man is hanging on the branch of a tree. So this tree basically is a friend, and that is in rest position, so it can be denoted by here with this spatial coordinates. So S frame, basically S frame of reference is this tree, and this particular observer is O. The man who is sitting on bike moving with the speed of 50 km per hour with respect to this person is the moving frame, that is S prime frame, and V is the relative speed of S prime frame, means speed of the bike relative to this person. So O prime is the observer, basically this man who is sitting on the bike, and V is the speed of the bike relative to this person or this tree, that is S. So this is the meaning of the frame of references. So we have converted all those basically real physical phenomena in terms of mathematics, and through that mathematics we have to define those observations. How basically this man observe and how this person observe according to the Galilean transformation, what will be their observation for any particular event. So I hope that now the idea of S and S prime frame is clear with this particular picture. And what is O and O prime? O prime is an observer who is associated with the S prime frame, and S prime frame is a moving frame relative to the S prime. Right, suppose now the second thing is an event occur into the S prime plane. So that event basically can be defined here with this P. So the coordinates of this event according to the observer O prime will be X prime, Y prime, Z prime and T prime. So all these spatial and time coordinates are in prime plane because this event is defined according to the O prime observer, so that will define in terms of the prime plane. And for this observer, this event will be X, Y, Z and T, unprime plane. He will measure this event into the unprime plane. So one is the prime and second is the unprime plane. And how basically those two observers will observe that event. So X prime, Y prime, Z prime, T prime is for whom? It is basically observation. Its observation will come through this by the O prime observer. And from the X, Y, Z and T, the equations or the observations will come by the observer O. So now we have to find out a relationship between these two coordinate system. One is prime and second is unprime. How one can convert prime plane into the unprime and unprime into the prime plane? So this is the transformation, right? We have to transform X prime into the X, Y prime into the Y, Z prime into the Z, T prime into the T. So this transformation of one coordinate system to the other is known as Galilean transformation. So according to this, as we have already mentioned that V is the relative speed of S prime plane which is moving along the positive X direction relative to the S, right? So now the coordinates of this event according to the observer O along the X axis. So X will be this distance from the observer is Y. Is this one up to here, and Z if you draw a projection here and you will try to connect this particular point, so it will be Z and time T. So because S prime plane is moving along the X axis positive X direction, this is positive, this is positive X direction, the forward direction basically, and X is the distance of this event for the observer O, and X prime is the distance along the X axis for the prime O prime observer. So if V is the relative speed of S prime plane, so one can find out the distance between these two inertial planes at any time t, and that distance will be Vt, where V is the velocity and t is the time. So here one can see that this x starts from here and end up to this point p is the sum of this Vt distance and X prime. So I am writing here this X is equal to X prime plus Vt, right? And Y is this particular height along the Y axis, And similarly for the O prime observer, the height remains same. So y is equal to y prime. And if I take the projection here of this point P and cut here along the z direction and cut here along the z direction, that also remains same. So z is equal to z prime. And similarly, T is equal to T prime. So in Galilean transformation, they assume that time is absolute. There is no change because of the relative motion, right? There is no change into the time because of the relative motion. Change comes into the coordinates, which coordinates only in spatial coordinate. So you see here that S prime plane is moving along the positive x direction, and here we observe that we found the change only in x coordinate. There is no change along there is no change in y and z coordinates. So it means the change comes into the coordinates, spatial coordinate. And in which coordinate that change will come? Along the direction, basically they moving from is this S prime plane is moving. So here S prime plane is moving along the positive x direction. So because of that, change is coming in x coordinate. Y and z remains same. But if suppose this S prime plane is moving along the y direction, this is S prime plane moving upward direction with the relative velocity v with respect to s. This is z, this one is y, this one again x prime, right? So this is S prime plane. So now S prime plane is moving in upward direction with respect to the S prime. So in which coordinate basically you will observe the change? In y coordinate. So x will remain same, but y will change because of the relative motion. And similarly, if along the z direction, if S prime plane is moving along the z direction, then the change will come into the z component, z coordinates. So here, this is the observation. This is x, y, z and t is equal to this one. And now according to the O prime, the transformation x prime is equal to x minus vt. So x prime is equal to x minus vt. Y prime is equal to y, z prime is equal to z, and t prime is equal to t. So these are relationship between the two coordinate system. One is the prime and second is the unprime. So here unprime plane, this is the prime plane, here prime plane, and their side is unprime plane. I have written here vt because t is equal to t prime. There was no any change into the time in this particular topic, Galilean transformation, because of the relative motion. So these set of equations are known as Galilean transformation. Now the next point, we have observed the coordinates x, y, z and their relationship with the other coordinate system. So now I want to find out the velocity. Suppose I throw a stone into the S prime plane. So what will be the velocity of that particle? Suppose that I am finding v. So v one can find out by differentiating this x with respect to t, right? dy upon dt, dz upon dt like this. So v is equal to dx upon dt is equal to dx prime upon dt plus v, here I am writing properly, d upon dt and vt. So one thing is here that this is dt, t, or we know that t is equal to t prime, so I am writing here this as a t prime, so it becomes t prime. And second thing is here, this v is the relative speed, and that relative speed remain constant. This v is constant because this is the relative velocity of s prime train with respect to s. So this derivation becomes, this step becomes dx upon dt is equal to, this dx prime upon dt prime is ux plus dv upon dt 0 because v is constant, so dt upon dt is equal to 1, right? So ux plus v, so here we are getting v ux prime plus v, dx prime upon dt prime is equal to ux prime. And here d upon dt, because v is constant, when you will differentiate v, dv upon dt 0, and you will get t, t into 0, 0. So in the next, this is sum of product, differentiation of that, so you will get v and into dt upon dt, that will be v. So now further, I have to find out the acceleration. And for that, again I have to differentiate it with respect to t. So dv upon dt is acceleration into the unprime plane. So ax is equal to differentiation of it with respect to time, again dux prime upon dt plus dv upon dt. And t is equal to t prime, so I can write here dt prime, and this you can say either you write t or t prime does not matter, because here v is, you are differentiating v with respect to time, and v is a constant velocity, so it is equal to 0. And here this is dux prime upon dt prime, so this one is ax prime. So ax is equal to ax prime. So what one can conclude from this result? We are getting that acceleration of the unprime plane is equal to the acceleration of prime plane. It means acceleration in both the planes remain constant. If acceleration is constant of both the planes, it means both the planes are inertial. So one can conclude from here that these frames are inertial or non-inertial. If these frames satisfy this particular condition, one can say that these frame of references will be inertial frame of references. So directly, indirectly, you can conclude from here. So this was the idea of Galilean transformation. But here we have considered that S prime plane, which is a moving plane along the x axis, we have considered that S prime plane is moving along the x axis, along the y axis, and along the z axis. And according to that, the change in the coordinate system. So in the first case, I have considered that S prime plane is moving along the positive x direction. So because of that, these are the, these is the set of equations. But if this S prime plane is moving along the y direction, so we will write the set of equations like this: x is equal to x prime, y is equal to y prime plus vt, z is equal to z prime, and t is equal to t prime. So this will be the set of equations when S prime plane is moving along the positive y direction, and similarly it will be for the z direction. So here one can conclude all these results, and for each set of equations we will get the same result, that acceleration basically remain constant. But if suppose S prime plane is not moving along the x direction, y direction or z direction, are not moving along these axes, that basically moving into the free space, that is not situated along the x direction, not situated along the y direction, and neither along the z direction, that is situated into the free space. So you can imagine, suppose this is a one coordinate system and I am here, right, at this particular point like this. This is the situation, one is in coordinate, another coordinate system is into the space, not like into this particular direction, along the x axis or about that axis, that is into the free space. And now in this particular situation, what will be the Galilean transformation, what will be the relationship between the coordinate system? So now in Galilean transformation, the point is that S prime plane is not moving along the positive x direction, it is basically into the free space. So we are reading Galilean transformation, and in Galilean transformation we have seen the set of equations when S prime plane is moving along the positive x direction, positive y direction and positive z direction. So now the point is that S prime plane is moving, this is S prime plane, this is x prime, y prime and z prime directions, and here is the O prime observer. So we are saying that S prime plane is moving in a free space, not along the x axis, not along the y axis and not along the z axis, it is in free space. So the coordinates, this is the radial distance from origin to origin, and you can say this is vector r. An event basically occur here into the S prime plane that can be defined according to the O prime observer, x prime, y prime, z prime, t prime, and according to this O, this will be x, y, z and t. Now how basically this particular topic is different from the, or this particular case is different from the earlier three cases of the Galilean transformation, where we have discussed that the S prime plane is moving along the x direction, y direction or z direction. Here basically in this particular case we have to see the velocity component. We know that vector v can be defined as vxi plus vyj plus vzk, and this vector v basically is the, well, vector v, from where this vector v is coming, this vector v is coming from the relative motion, relative motion between the S prime and S prime, and v is the relative speed. But right now V is coming in terms of the component Vx, Vy, Vz. Velocity component along the x-axis, y-axis and along the z direction. So instead of writing only V, we have to write now the velocity component Vx, Vy and Vz. So now the change will come into all the three coordinates, whether that is x, y or z. So in this particular case, the Galilean transformation will be x prime is equal to x minus vx t, y prime is equal to y minus vy t, z prime is equal to z minus vz t, and similarly t prime is equal to t. So this is the set of equations into this particular case for the Galilean transformation. When S prime plane is in free space, then that time we have to consider the all three components of the velocity, and in all the three coordinates we will observe the change. And because of that, further one can find out the relationship between the velocity, between the acceleration. And if the S and S prime planes are inertial, we will observe that acceleration into the S plane, acceleration into the S prime plane will be same. So Ax is equal to Ax prime, Ay is equal to Ay prime, and similarly Az will be equal to Az prime if these frame of references are inertial. So this was the basic topic, first topic of the special theory of relativity, where we have discussed about the Galilean transformation. And in the next lecture we will see that what was the drawback of the Galilean transformation and where we face the difficulty to implement this particular idea of Galilean transformation. So what modification basically came into existence further, what the form of the new relationship, what is that called this in a special theory of relativity. So that will be the plan of the next lecture, and further we will see and read about the length contraction, time dilation, velocity addition, mass energy relationship. Right, if you have any problem in any concept of this particular lecture, you can write that message. Thanks for watching this video.